In this video, we'll take a look at frequency distribution tables. Frequency distribution tables are used for quickly summarizing or tabulating a number of values. We'll take a look at how to create a frequency distribution table next. Suppose we have the following values with scores for 12 people on the variable x. Here we'll make a table where we'll tabulate or count the frequency for each value of x. First, let's take a look at the different possible values of x that we have in our data set. So notice in our above example that we have the values of 20. There's no 21 here, but we have 22, 23, 24, and 25. So we have 20 through 25 where 21 is missing. And there are also multiple values for some. So for example, there's 1, 2, 3, 4 23s in this example. But in summary, we have the values 20 through 25 where 21 is missing. So as I indicated a few moments ago, we have those values of x that I said, and there's no value of 21. However, because 21 occurs between the lowest and highest values, so it's in that range, we'll include it in our table. In creating our table, we'll start by listing the values for x, beginning with the largest value first. So as I mentioned previously, we'll begin with x. We'll make a column for x, as you see on your screen, and we'll start with 25, and then we'll move all the way down here. So we have 25, 24, 23, 22. We included this 21, even though there were no values of 21 up here, and that's because it's inside this range here. And then we have 20. Next, we'll need to make a column for f, which represents the frequency, or the number of times that each value occurred. We'll count the number of times each value occurs and we'll list it in the table under F or frequency. So starting with the highest value, notice that there is 125, okay, and then 24 there's 1, 2, 2 values of 24, and we could go ahead and count or tabulate the rest. Notice for 25 we have 1 as I'd indicated. So this F indicates the frequency or how many of a given value occurred in our data set. So we have one value of 25, we have two values of 24, we have four values of 23, let's check that, 1, 2, 3, 4. We have two values of 22, so let's double check that, 1, 2. We have no 21s as we saw before, so notice how we include a zero here when there are no occurrences of that value. And then we have three values of 20. Let's check that. So we have 1, 2, 3 20s. Okay, so it's very important to remember here that F stands for the frequency and X is the original value. So F tells you how many of the X's that you actually have. We have 1, 25, 2, 24s, and so on. And that's really all there is to it for creating a frequency distribution table. Now, once this is created, there's some advantages that we didn't have when the numbers were just listed. We can look at this table, focusing on the frequency column for a moment, and we can quickly identify the value that occurred the most often or most frequently. And that is, we look here and we see that the largest frequency is 4, and that corresponds to a score or a value of 23. So 23 occurred the most often. And that's also known as the mode, or the most frequently occurring value. So in this example, we would say that the mode is 23. The value that occurred the least often is 21, as it did not occur at all. Okay, that's it for creating frequency distribution tables. Thanks for watching.